atmosphere. This will be a fun one.
Dayson Fowles will jump it against Tyler Coleman. Tip is up. Fowles will control it, and Derek Smith will run it down to the backcourt for Delta. Derek will walk it up the floor. He'll kick it high left side to Dutson. Dutson holding high. Now works it to the top of the key. Can hesitate. Looks to drive. Goes to Smith right side. Smith gets in the lane. Back to Dutson right side. He'll take the three from the wing. Short off the rim. On the board. It's on the floor. Eventually picked up by the Braves. That was Blancas that came down to it. Now Hunsaker will bring it up the floor for North Summit. He'll bring it across the timeline. Delta going to go to a 2-3 zone. Right side, it's going to go to Richens.
You're going to notice they're going to try and double down inside every time they can.
Short corner on the baseline. 15-footer is going to be missed by Stevens. Mm-hmm. Long rebound taken by Richens. He'll kick it out to Hunsaker. He drives the lane. Pass inside to Stevens. One dribble on the low block. Puts up the baby hook off the back of the rim and falls. 2-0 North Summit.
Yeah, just hung and hung and hung and finally dropped through. And that was my point in the start the pregame or in the pregame. Delta has to defend the glass. They cannot give North Summit second right. chance points. And there's two already.
Jamin Bruff will hand off to Derek Smith offensively for the Rabbits. Right side it goes to Dutson. Dutson goes back to Smith on a backdoor cut. Puts it up.
Whoa.
Off the glass. Blocked off the glass by Blomquist. What a putback by Dayson Fowles. Tie ball game.
I thought that might have been pinned up on the glass at first, but they let the play go on, and Dayson Fowles, Johnny on the spot to pick that up.
Richens right side, skip pass into the corner, goes to Stevens. To the wing it comes to Blomquist, guarded tightly by Bruff. Got by him, lost his footing on the floor. The ball is loose. It's picked up by Dayson Fowles for the Rabbits. Turnover by North Summit's there first.
Love the energy already by the Rabbits.
Lob up ahead, wide open is Trevor Burton underneath. Scoop it up off the glass, got it to fall.
Beautiful energy, and they see Burton down the floor all alone, and he has to go up and under, uses the rim to protect the ball, and gets the layup.
4-2 Delta now is your score on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. Driving the lane is Hunsaker, fakes the pass, goes inside to Coleman, and Coleman away on the left side. Coleman now with his first bucket, ties it up at four.
Yeah, he catches it down low. There's nothing you can do. He is so big and physical to go up with it.
Derek Smith going to go right by his man, kick it into the corner. Burton for the long two, air ball hard, rebound Stevens.
Never caught it clean on the pass, and I don't think he had a good grip when he went up to shoot that.
Hunsaker now brings it across the timeline for the Braves. 2-3 zone by the Rabbits. Right side will go. Short corner inside it goes to Coleman. And Coleman again got around his man and lays it in easy. He's got four.
Yeah, they're going to have to double. They're going to put somebody on the front side and then bring the weak side behind to help because he's just too big to try and defend down in there.
Dutson works his way left side. Guarded by Stevens, goes up the screen, tries the pick and roll to Burton, and good defense by the Braves. They come over the steal. Blomquist going the other way, going to drive right side, scoop it up off the glass and in. Blomquist the bucket, he's got 2 points, and now it's 8-4, North Summit on a 6-0 run.
That's that athleticism Coach Toppin was talking about in the pregame. He can just rise up over people.
Jack Dutson, crossover dribble, goes left off the screen. Dayson Fowles got ran over. Ball went to Derek Smith in the corner. He'll kick it up top to Burton. Burton going to fake left, goes right, hands to Dutson. Dutson for three. Off the back of the rim, high bounce, hit the, what is that, the wires above?
Yeah.
I guess that's what you'd call it, the wires above. So dead ball, North Summit basketball.
And there really should have been a foul as North Summit ran through that high pick of Dayson Fowles. I mean, ran through it. They put him on his backside. Referees are letting him play here early.
Full court press right now by the Rabbits, 1-2-2 zone press. In the backcourt, it's going to be Richens. Across the timeline, he goes to Hunsaker. He'll drive the lane, scoop it up the right hand off the back of him. Good. Got his own rebound. Getting battled underneath, and they're going to call a foul inside on Delta. It's going to go against Jack Dutson. So Dutson picks up his first and the team's first.
And I thought Delta, they tried to step in and take the charge there. A lot of contact. One of those that could have gone either way, they just chose to let it go. So
lob into Coleman. He'll catch and shoot off the glass left side. Coleman now with a game-high six. And it's now 10-4 North Summit.
And averages 11 and already has six.
Jamin Bruff left side to the short corner. Burton for the long two. Knocks it down. Trevor Burton to the 17-footer. He's got four.
That time he made a nice clean catch and rose up and hit the 16-footer. He loves that baseline shot and is just so good at it.
Hunsaker in the backcourt. Guarded by Bruff. He'll bring it across the timeline. Goes left side now to Blomquist. Guarded by Dutson in the zone. Back out to Hunsaker. Bruff going to come out on him. Left side will go to Blomquist. Right back to Hunsaker. Top of the key. He'll work his way right side. Looks in the lane. Wide open underneath was Stevens. And he'll lay it in easily as they're shredding the zone right now of Delta's defense.
Yeah, I'd be so worried about Coleman in there that Stevens just snuck along the baseline underneath and there was nobody there to guard him.
Right side, Burton has it. Goes in the corner to Smith. Ball gets knocked loose. He got it back but stepped on the sidelines. Turnover by Delta will be there first.
And I don't like that call simply because Derek kind of took a bump and got shoved that way. And kind of got pushed as he went to the out-of-bounds line.
Not sure what they're checking. They were checking the shot by Trevor Burton. Initially, the scoreboard put 7 as a three-pointer.
Yeah, it was a
They
two.
Did change it back, and it's been changed back for a while, but they
want to make sure.
Still wanted to make sure they had it correct. So 12-6 is your score. North Summit doubling up Delta right now on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. Full court press again by the Rabbits. They'll get it across easily, does North Summit. Hunsaker, though, loses the handle on the dribble. Picked up by Smith, and Smith's going to be fouled. Yep. And the foul's going to go against Jace Richens. That'll be his first and the team's first.
Probably saved a bucket because Derek Smith was off with it and had a man streaking down the right side. So as much contact as we've seen out here tonight, that's just one foul on each team so far.
Yes, it is. 3:39 to go in the first quarter. 12-6 Braves on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. Across the timeline comes Bruff. Crossover dribble against Hunsaker, and Hunsaker takes it away. Hunsaker going the other way for the Braves. Going to push the pace. Bounces right side to Coleman. Pump fake. Step back. 15-foot fadeaway. Knocks it down. Coleman now with 8.
Are you kidding me? That's a step back from the big kid. Impressive.
Timeout called by Coach Topham with 3:22 to go in the first quarter on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. It's North Summit 14, Delta 6. We'll take the break on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
Service Drug in Delta announces a new way to save money on your gasoline purchases. Service Drug has partnered with Silver Eagle and Delta to offer greater savings to customers of both businesses. When you spend over $50 at Service Drug, you can save 5 cents per gallon on fuel. Spend over $75 and receive a 10 cents per gallon discount. Spend over $100 and receive 15 cents a gallon on your next purchase at Silver Eagle. So shop at your locally owned hometown businesses and begin saving right away. As always, it's service first at Service Drug. Some restrictions apply. See store for details.
To 6 is your score coming out of the timeout. Delta trails North Summit by 8 here in the first quarter. 3:22 to go in the quarter on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. What do you expect to see from Coach Topham out of that timeout?
Well, just try to get him to settle down just a little bit. We're trying to penetrate into the teeth of the defense, and just can't do it now. There, Dason Fowles takes a knee. That's got to be it. But once again, they're so aggressive on defense, our North Summit. You just got to be patient.
Jack Dudson with kind of an ISO situation there. Goes off the screen, misses the shot. Rebound, though, by Bruff. Out to Burton for 3. Off the rim, no good. Rebound will be taken by Stevens. There's going to be a foul called. Is it on Fowles or Smith? And it's going to go against Dason Fowles. So that's Dason's first and the team's second.
Well, give Jamin Bruff a lot of credit. He went in amongst the big tall timber and got the offensive rebound. Gave Delta a second crack at it. It just wouldn't go down. And those opportunities, they've just got to go for Delta to hang in this one.
And it was a good look for Burton as well.
Absolutely.
Hunsaker has it left side high, guarded tightly by Smith now as Delta brings out their defense further. Into the corner it goes to Coleman. Coleman lobs back up top to Hunsaker. Swing it left side to Stevens. He'll turn and hit the quick 3, in and out. Rebound, though, by Richens down the lane. He'll kick it back out to Hunsaker. He'll drive in. Pass right side
There's
to Coleman.
An offensive
foul is the call. Dason Fowles draws the charge. The foul on Hunsaker will be his first. And the third turnover by North Summit.
Yeah, great job by Dason Fowles. He saw the drive coming, stepped over in front, took the contact. Both officials had it going that way.
Bo Nilsson into the game for Jamin Bruff for the Rabbits with 2:34 to go in this first quarter. Still 14-6, no points scored in about a minute.
And those of you that are watching here, and you can probably tell on the radio too, the athleticism that North Summit brings. Every one of them out there can flat out get up and down the floor and very, very quick off the floor as well.
Dudson goes backdoor pass to Smith. Smith reverse layup blocked by Coleman, who recovered nicely, and he came down with it.
Boy, just when you think you're going to get an easy one, out of nowhere comes Tyler Coleman to block that away.
Hunsaker watch it across the timeline for the Braves. Right side it'll go to Richens. Looking in, not there. Up top it'll come back to Hunsaker. Left side it goes to Longquist. Skip pass right side to Richens. Pump fake on the 15-footer. Drives in, gets cut off, kicks it out to Stevens for the 15-footer, and he'll knock it down. Stevens with 6. 16-6, North Summit.
Yeah, they're shooting the ball well. This team, you can see why they're on a 6-game winning streak. And there they got it.
And Jack Dudson went off the screen of Dason Fowles, and Dason did get ran over by Stevens. So Stevens picks up his first foul, the team's third. Remains Delta basketball on the near side. Derek Smith will inbound, but not before Brett Roundy comes into the game, and coming out will be Dason Fowles. So match Tyler Coleman with Brett Roundy. Derek Smith will inbound. He'll just go into the backcourt to Jack Dudson. Dudson will walk it across the timeline. 1:45 to go in the quarter, picked up by Stevens. He'll go right side to Smith. Guarded by Richens, looking for Roundy, can't get it to him. Behind the back dribble as he goes in, now goes low to Roundy. Roundy put it up over Coleman,
nice.
Got it to fall.
Beautiful move. And so there's the counter that Coach Topham comes with. He's got to counter the size of Coleman and comes in with Brett Roundy, and immediately it pays off.
about the same height, but even bigger is Roundy. Right side driving is Richens. Nice pass underneath, but taken away by Dutson. Jack coming the other way for the Rabbits. He'll lob up ahead left side to Nielsen. Nielsen runs it down to the baseline, but couldn't quite save it. And it's picked up by Hunsaker for the Braves. Hunsaker going the other way. Behind the back dribble, down the lane. Puts it up, off the glass and in. Hunsaker, he's got his first bucket of the game.
Yeah, beautiful move by Hunsaker. Avoids the contact and takes it up and lays it in.
Derek Smith right side, and he's going to be tied up as he went up for the shot. Jump ball. Possession arrow favors North Summit. Fourth turnover now by Delta. Didn't know the help defense was there behind the trailing defender, and that's who got him as he was going to pull up for the shot.
And other than the layup that was blocked underneath, I'm not sure if Derek Smith has taken a shot in this first quarter. That the jump ball right there, but.
Right. Into the game now for North Summit's going to be Stockton Richens. Left side, three-pointer by Stevens, and he'll knock it down. Daniel Stevens now with 9. That's a game high, and it's the largest lead of the night. 21-8, North Summit, 44 seconds left in the quarter.
That's a kid that averages 6.5, Robert, and already he's got 9.
Dutson dribbles down the lane and just kind of kept dribbling before until North Summit took it away. Back to the way comes Stevens. Off the glass, got it to fall again. Stevens now with 11. Up the floor comes the Dutson. 25 seconds left in the first quarter here. Play call comes in from Coach Topham. Delta down 15 in the first quarter. Dutson yo-yos. They're going to play for the final shot of this first quarter. He's going to be guarded by Stockton Richens. Hesitates. Going to drive right side. Pull up on the elbow. Hand to Smith for 3 from the right wing. Off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound Hunsaker for the Braves. Hunsaker going to push the pace the other way. 6 seconds left. Crossover dribble goes by Smith and scoop it up and got it to fall. Hunsaker with 4, and that's going to be how the first quarter comes to an end.
Wow.
North Summit leads 25-8 on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. We'll take the 60-second break on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
The Intermountain Power Service Corporation is proud to bring you this presentation. IPSC is a community-minded company that contributes to our local schools, community organizations, and economy. The Intermountain Power Project consistently ranks among the best of America's coal-based power plants in reliability, cost-effectiveness, and environmental responsibility. Intermountain Power Service Corporation strives for perfection and is honored to be actively involved with Delta, Millard, and Juab High Schools.
At Orem High School, Robert Lovell with you alongside Ken Nielsen. At the end of the first quarter, North Summit goes on a 9-0 run to end the quarter. They lead at 25-8 over Delta. Delta basketball to start this second quarter. Smith up top, shakes the defense, goes left side to Dutson. Dutson dribbles into the elbow, puts up the runner from 15 feet, too high and hard off the glass. Rebound, North Summit.
You know, I was looking here. North Summit's ranked 5th in the state. I was wondering whether they were worthy of that ranking. Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
In fact, I may even have them even up maybe that third spot. They're playing that well.
And then Dayson Fowl is going to be here with the foul as he comes over the back of Tyler Coleman. And the foul on fouls will be his second and the team's third. Brett Roundy off the bench to come in for Dayson. And Jake Day comes into the game for Jack Dutson for the Rabbits. 7:34 to go here in the first quarter. North Summit basketball trying to extend their 17-point lead. Lobin will go right inside to Coleman. He'll hand off in the corner to Richens. That's Stockton. He'll come out to Jace Richens. Now back to Stockton. Loblin low block to Coleman, working on Roundy. Double team comes. There's a 12-foot fadeaway. Got it to fall.
Once again, he's a spin move and fades away. This might be the best big man I've seen this year so far. He's just got a touch.
27-8. Left side Burton looks to drive baseline. He's going to be fouled on the drive by Stevens. That'll be the second foul on Daniel Stevens and the fourth team foul on North Summit.
In fact, Robert, I am surprised that he only averages 11 points per game.
Yeah.
He is so good around the basket. But that says something about the team concept at North Summit as well.
Blanc was back into the game for Stevens, who picked up his second foul. Left side, Jake Day, 15-footer off the inbound pass. Air ball hard. Rebound going to be taken by Blanc for the Braves. Hunsaker will bring it up the floor now for North Summit. Guarded tightly by Bruff as he does. Delta has now gone to a man defense. Ruff picking him up top. High left, he's going to throw it to Richens. That's Stockton Richens. And he'll come around and go back to Hunsaker, but threw it up too far out in front of him, and out of bounds it goes. Turnover by North Summit is their fifth.
Yeah, good adjustment there by Coach Topham to go to the man. Kind of changed things up there, and North Summit did not respond well to it right there. So there's no need to panic yet. There's so much game still to be played. We saw Manti get down big early earlier today, and they came back and took the lead and almost got that win. So don't panic. Stay with your game plan.
Jim Mbrough going to drive in. Blocked by Coleman on the runner. Picked up by Jace Richens. Down the floor he comes to Blomquist. One dribble. He'll kick it out left side to Stockton Richens. Pull up for three from the wing. Off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound tipped out. And it's going to be Blomquist that has it for the Braves. And up top now, Hunsaker controls it as they set up their offense. Crossover dribble against Bruff. Gets in the lane. Bounce pass to Coleman, who wasn't expecting it, but still caught it. And misses the bank shot from 12 feet out. Rebound, Jamin Bruff. Defense coming from behind. Didn't know it. Able to avoid the turnover. Up top, he'll go to Smith. Smith, top of the key. Left side, he goes to Burton. Short corner goes to Bruff. Out to Day. Up top, back to Burton. Through his hands. And that's going to be a turnover by the Rabbits. That'll be their sixth.
Yeah, can't afford to have those. Those are kind of unforced right there, where it just kind of goes through the hands. But how about Tyler Coleman? He's doing it on both ends. Yeah. Rebounding, hits the fadeaway. Block shots, that's at least two
Yeah,
remember.
Two, and then Blomquist has one too, yeah. Yep. Jack Dutson into the game for Jake Day for the Rabbits. Hunsaker has it up top right now for North Summit. Right side, it'll go to Jace Richens. Into the corner to Coleman. Guarded by Roundy, he'll lob inside to Blomquist. Guarded tightly by Burton, 12-foot fadeaway. And on the rebound, it's going to be Jace Richens. Came out of nowhere to pick up the board. He loses the handle, though, picked up by Trevor Burton. So turnover by North Summit. Now Burton's going to be fouled by Blomquist. That'll be the first on Blomquist and the fifth team foul. The North Summit crowd doesn't like it.
A lot of contact both ways on that end of the floor there, and Delta fortunate to come away now with the ball. They need a bucket right here, Robert. They've got to get cut into this lead a little bit right here.
Currently an 11-0 run for North Summit. Delta trails 27-8, and there's a turnover. Jace Richens steps in front of the pass, takes it away, and Derek Smith trying to get back defensively just ran into him, and that'll be the foul on Derek. That's his first fourth team foul, and seven turnovers now for Delta.
Yeah, Delta's just got to settle down. We were a little worried coming in on this big stage here in front of the big, big crowd, a vocal crowd also.
Yeah.
And Delta's just got to somehow weather the storm right here, keep your composure, get a stop right here, and let's go back down and see if you can get some offense going.
Parker Brown into the game for North Summit. 5:18 to go in the first quarter, 27-8, the Braves. Crossover drew by Hunsaker, bounce pass left side to Blomquist, misses the layup on the left side, rebound taken by Roundy for the Rabbits.
Yeah, he just almost looked like he wanted to go up, dunk it, and then left it short with two hands up near the rim.
Burton in the corner, inside to Roundy. Roundy puts it up high off the glass. No good, but a foul called. And Brett Roundy will go to the line to shoot two. The foul's going to be called on Hayden Blomquist. It'll be his second and the team's sixth.
Yeah, good choice. Go down in there with Brett Roundy and let him take it right in up against the big kids. Brett's been really a bright spot for Delta here in the first half.
First free throw is short off the rim. First free throw taken tonight, period.
Yeah.
Despite the physicality of the game.
Exactly.
Jace Richens back in for North Summit, and I mentioned to Coach Priest, I said, well, yeah, you have to have at least one Richens as a starter, don't you? He said, yeah, that's what they told me when I took the job, that has to be a Richens starting.
Absolutely.
Whether it's boys or girls, there seem to be many Richens on the North Summit rosters. Second free throw for Roundy is good. He makes one of two. He's got three for Delta. Timeout called by Coach Topham. Topham with, I'm assuming that's 5 minutes and 10 seconds and not 50 minutes and 10 seconds. There we go, 5:01. Is how much time is left in the second quarter. On the Eagles Landing scoreboard, it is at North Summit 27, Delta 8. We'll take the break on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
Have you heard? Central Valley Medical Center is now providing orthopedic surgery. That's right, Dr. Joel Holman is a full-time orthopedic surgeon practicing in Nephi. You no longer need to drive to the Wasatch Front for hip replacement, knee replacement, fracture care, hand surgery, and general orthopedic care. Dr. Holman completed a residency in general orthopedics and a fellowship in hand surgery at the U of U and sees patients in the Nephi Medical Clinic inside Central Valley Medical Center. Call 435-623-3633, 623-3633.
Blackburn Recreation and Supply in Bicknell is Wayne County's not-so-little secret. From CF Moto ATVs, fishing, hunting, and camping supplies to farming and yard and field care products and ATV parts, Blackburn Recreation and Supply has got you covered. And when it's time to get the right tools for the job, they'll be waiting for you at M&D Auto Parts in Bicknell. For O'Reilly Auto Parts, done right, do business with M&D Auto Parts.
And rushing back here to the Fieldhouse Forum High School. 27-9 your score, 5 minutes to go in the first half. North Summit right now in a dominant performance over Delta. And we've got a timeout. The net is messed up. So, is that what you were trying to get him to fix there, Ken?
I just said, hey, Curtis, the net's hung up. Then I realized, well, that's on North Summit's basket. So leave it up. Let's see if maybe that'll keep the ball from going there through the basket for him. No, it's a quality team, this Braves team. They have come in here, and they are hitting on all cylinders.
Hunsaker, crossover dribble, drives in with the finger roll off the glass and in, right over the front of the rim for Calvin Hunsaker. He's got six.
They have to bring help for him as well, because it's just it's almost unfair to try and guard him one-on-one out front.
Derek Smith has it left side. Dribbles around, gets in the lane, kicks it up top to Bruff. Bruff couldn't quite handle it, now runs it down near the timeline. Right side, he'll go to Dutson. Dutson looking inside for Roundy. Skip pass underneath to Derek Smith. Smith, one dribble, puts it up on the amongst the trees. Oh. In and out. Rebound goes to Smith. One dribble in the lane, puts it up off the glass. Counted, he's fouled. Derek Smith the bucket and the chance of the three-point play.
The freshman just hanging with it, not giving up on the play. Picks up the loose ball and then goes in and takes the contact. Playing with a mask, which is not easy to do, because it gets fogged up, it gets sweaty. That's a tough thing to do, and he's really handled it well. Has playing with a broken nose, but they're going to need his offense here tonight. Let's see if that kind of gets him going.
Jake Day back into the game for Delta. Trevor Burton will come out. That was the first bucket of the game for Smith. He's going to try to add to his point total with his and one free throw. Shot is up and good. Nothing but net for Smith. He's got three. 29-12 is your score. North Summit up by 17 on the Eagles Landing scoreboard.
How much fun is Derek Smith going to be to watch the next 3 years for Coach Curtis Topham?
Off
and
the screen
Jamin
goes
Bruff.
Hunsaker. Looking inside, not there. He'll skip right side to Stockton Richens. Back to Hunsaker, left side, going to dribble in against Round. He's stripped by Smith. Derek with the steal. He's going the other way, trying to get ahead of the defense, and he'll be stripped on the way down the floor. Out of bounds it goes. It'll be Delta basketball underneath.
Yeah, nice effort there by the freshman to take the ball away and take it down. They'll have a possession now, shot at the basket. Maybe a little bit of a run right here for the Rabbits. See if they can't cut into this. You know, get it down to 12-14 before the half, and you can go in feeling somewhat comfortable.
Into the game is Daniel Stevens for North Summit. Pass will come into Jake Day. Right back to Dutson. Right side on the wing to Smith for three. Short on the rim. Rebound by Day. He'll kick it back up to Smith. Pump fake on the three. Dribbles in. Goes inside to Roundy. Couldn't quite catch it. And it's picked up by Hunsaker. Turnover by Delta is their eight.
Yeah, good idea, but to the pass just a little bit too low for Big Brett Roundy to try and reach down and pick it up.
Hunsaker up top, guarded by Bruff. Works his way right side. Going to dribble in with the left hand. Kick it into the corner. Open for three is Stevens. Off the back side of the rim. No good. Roundy the rebound. And he's going to be fouled by Coleman, who pulled it away. And the foul on Coleman will be his first. Team's eighth, and Roundy will go to the line to shoot 1-1.
So a chance to score with the clock stopped right here. Just chip away at it, Robert. You know, you've been in this situation before. You're usually on top, though, but I've been on the bottom of these things. And you just look for little small victories as you move along. You still have a whole half and only almost nearly a half of a quarter here. So just hang in there. Keep chipping away.
There's the front end of the 1-1 for Roundy. Got it. Brett Roundy now with 4 points off the bench. That's tied for a team high for Delta.
Looking at that sub of the game award. Is that what
That's
he's
right.
playing for here?
Yes, he is. Sub of the game brought to you by Timberline Inn in Beaver. Second free throw is good. So Roundy makes them both. He's got 5 points to lead Delta. 29-14 your score. 15-point edge for North Summit. Hunsaker will bring it across the timeline. Picked up by Bruff again. He's like the crossover going to his left, but this time he hands off to Coleman. Underneath, wide open is Jace Richens. He puts it up. Counted, he's fouled. Jace Richens the bucket and the chance of the three-point play. Not sure what happened there defensively, but he got lost and was left all alone.
I'll tell you what happened is the big kid, Tyler Coleman, is out on top with the ball, so everybody relaxes down low thinking we're okay underneath, and then somebody slips in just like right there in Richens, gets the bucket and the foul. So that's what a big kid like that will do for you that is so active. You're thinking, just for a minute, I can let my guard down because he's cleared the paint, and then someone else sneaks in.
Foul was called on Derek Smith, by the way, his second for Delta, so Trevor Burton back into the game for Derek. Here's the and one coming from Richens. First free throw of the game for North Summit. And knocks it down, so Richens now with 3 points.
He averages 9 a game. So they've got two players average 11, one that averages 9, another one 8.7, another 6.5. They shared it well.
Left side, Burton up top. He'll come to Dutson for the straightaway three. Off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound, Richens. Richens is somebody they need to look out for on the boards. He has
crashed the board. Did you see where he was at?
And he can jump.
He took that ball right off the rim. He was that high up.
Coleman for three from the left wing. Off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound, Jamin Brough for the Rabbits. And Jamin pushing the pace. Lost the handle, though, but he's going to be fouled on a reach-in. If it's on Richens, I believe it is, that will be his second. And going to the line to shoot one and one will be Brough.
And this is how you get back in the game, is you've got to convert on free throws.
Bo Nilton back in the game. Jake Day will check out for Delta. And Stockton Richens into the game for Jace Richens.
Thank goodness to get Jace Richens out of there. He honestly, from where you and I were sitting, he was up near the rim when he took that rebound off. He could really get off the floor.
The front end of the 1-1 for Brough is good. So Jamin will shoot another. He's got his first point of the game.
Jamin, another one of those great athletes that can get up off the floor.
One more free throw coming from Brough. Trying to cut the lead to 16, and he does. 32-16 as Norris somewhat doubling up Delta here with 2:48 to go in the second quarter on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. Eagles Landing and High Country Chevron at the I-15 north exit in Beaver. Hunsaker across the timeline, picked up by Brough. He'll go left side to Blomquist, guarded by Burton. Looking inside, not there. He'll go off the screen, heads by Roundy, and Roundy got the arm reached in there. So it'll be the first foul on Brett Roundy and the sixth team foul on Delta.
Yeah, and that was a good call. Just got caught reaching across. And right here, you got to be careful on the inbound. Look out for a Coleman.
Okay. Hunsaker drives the lane on the inbound, just crashes the lane, misses the layup, got his own rebound though, and makes the reverse layup. Hunsaker now with eight.
Wow. As soon as he hit the floor, he was right back up, getting the offensive rebound and the putback. You just cannot give those up.
Brough left side for three, knocks it down. Jamin Brough with a big triple. He's got five. That's a Dairy Farmers of America three-pointer.
Yeah, how about
that? It's a 15-point game.
Coming alive a little bit is Jamin Brough. They need him.
Yeah, they do. He was one of the ones that Coach Topham mentioned in the pregame show coach's comments. If he can hit big shots at big moments. Up top, Coleman, the 16-footer. Hard off the glass and in. He got it to fall. The bank is open.
Can't count that one. He banked that one in from straight away. The kid has such a soft touch. But be interested to see if anybody's looking at him.
Burton going to drive right side in the lane. He's going to be fouled as he goes up for the shot. And it's going to go against Tyler Coleman. So that'll be Coleman's second. And Burton will go to the line to shoot two for Delta. 10th team foul as well.
Trevor had a couple of quick buckets early in the ball game. Kind of got off quick. Maybe this will help him get going again.
1:47 to go in the half. North Summit 36, Delta 19. Here's the first free throw from Burton. In and out. Into the game, Chase fouls for Delta. Roundy will come out. And the game for North Summit is going to be Marin Winters. And coming out is Tyler Coleman with his two fouls.
I stood by him over in the corner of the court watching a previous game, and he is big kid. Boy, he's a big physical kid.
Burton misses the second free throw. Short rebound by Stevens. 1:43 to go in the half. North Summit's led by as many as 19 in this game. They lead by 17 now. Left elbow Stevens. He'll go right elbow to Winters. Nothing inside. Left elbow to Richens. Ball gets tipped away by Nilsson. Nilsson taps it away. Runs it down. Saves it.
Wow.
Into Dutson. Dutson going to go left side down the lane. Scoop it up.
Whoa.
Misses short, and he'll be fouled. Jack Dutson's going to go to the line to shoot two.
He took a pretty good shot as he went to the basket. What a great effort, though, by Bo Nilsson to tip it away and then save it right in front of the score table.
Stockton Richens picks up his second foul for North Summit. They've got five players with two fouls each so far for the Braves.
That last possession down here, North Summit was running the old spot offense. Delta's, you know, they run that themselves. It's just so hard to defend. And so we'll see if they get back into that spot. I love the spot offense. Very predictable, but yet it's so hard to defend. And Delta not helping themselves, Robert, here from the line.
Dutson missed the first free throw from the Miller County Credit Union free throw line. Second free throw rattles that one in. All five starters have now scored for Delta with that point from Jack Dutson. Makes it 36-20. North Summit still up by 16. A minute 18 to go in the half. Hunsaker across the timeline. He'll go left side to Blomquist. Up top, he'll come to Winters. Nothing on the curl. He'll go right side to Hunsaker. Drives the lane. Got cut off at the free throw line. Hands off to Stevens for the straightaway three. Off the glass. Whoa. Missed it. Didn't draw iron. Rebound taken by Chase Fowles. He'll hand it to Burton. Burton down the left side of the floor. Cut off by Blomquist. He'll come up top to Dutson.
What we were saying, get this down to 12 or 14 and you can feel a little better about yourself.
Pump fake on the three by Brough. He'll drive the lane, puts up the shot, off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound tipped up by Brough, but Hunsaker comes down with it. Hunsaker pushing the pace for North Summit. Going to go right side of the pass to Blomquist, off the glass, got it to fall.
Beautiful drive and layoff to Blomquist. You step over to try and take a charge and he just lays it off to the running wing.
Jack Dutson right side. And they're going to have a foul on Chase Fowles, trying to establish position underneath. So the foul on Fowles will be his first. And the 17th foul, but an offensive foul, and that'll be the ninth turnover by Delta.
And I don't like that call either, Robert, because all he's doing, he's just posting up, much like both teams are doing on either side. All the contact that's been going on in this ball game, and he said he was reaching around behind, establishing position on the floor. That's a tough, tough call for Coach Topham. You can tell he's frustrated right here.
Down 18, 38, 20, 32 seconds left in the half here on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. Up the floor comes Calvin Hunsaker, going to play for the final shot of the quarter, I believe, Will North Summit. As he crosses the timeline, he will yo-yo, letting the clock run down. Down to 16 seconds left in the half. Trying to go in up 20 is North Summit. 10 seconds left. Hunsaker starts to go into action. Off the screen of Stevens, left side, hesitates, looks to drive, and puts up the runner high off the glass. Soft touch, got it to fall. What a shot by Hunsaker. And that's going to be how the first half comes to an end. It's North Summit 40 and Delta 20 on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. We'll take a two-minute break and come back with our Jones and the Mill Engineering Halftime Show on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
You've seen Zions Bank's name at sporting events, performances, and fundraisers. We're just about everywhere. Your children and grandchildren see Zions' dedicated employees in their classroom, teaching them how to save. We do all this because we have skin in the game. We support South Central Utah because we live and work here too. So we're as committed to this community's future as you are. When it comes to choosing to bank at Zions, rest assured you're selecting a company dedicated to bringing value to South Central Utah's businesses, individuals, and families.
ZionsBank.com, member FDIC.
'Hare Motors is your no-problem car dealer. Hot weather, no problem. Cold weather, no problem. New car, no problem. Used car, no problem. Not sure what fits your lifestyle and budget? No problem. Not sure if you can afford it? No problem. Stop by 'Hare Motors and talk to the no-problem professionals. You'll only have one question when you leave. What took you so long to buy from 'Hare Motors? Just north of Delta and in Ely, Nevada.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
Oh hey, you know, every student's journey is important, and Snow College offers its students an epic adventure at an affordable cost. And what student doesn't want a quality education? Unfortunately, taking generals at a university sometimes makes you feel like just another number. But at Snow College, you can look forward to small class sizes, professors that know your name, and with a higher than average graduation and transfer rate.
Hey Chance.
Oh hey, what's up? You can continue on to the school of your choice. Begin your journey now. Visit snow.edu.
And we welcome back here to the field house at Orem High School. Robert Lovell with you alongside Ken Nilsson. This is the Jones and the Mill Engineering Halftime Show. Jones and the Mill Engineering, from slam dunks to buzzer beaters. The Jones and the Mill Engineering team is here to help you tackle the toughest infrastructure issues. Appreciate Jones and Mill Engineering, our halftime show sponsor. At the half, North Summit doubling up Delta 40-20 right now. North Summit has looked dominant and has been dominant in this first half. Ken, your reaction?
You know, all day long as I've been up here watching games, I look at the seeds that they've come into the tournament, and I've looked at the rankings, and it seems like every game before it starts, I think, you know, I'm not is this team really as good as they're being touted? Is this game deserve a this team deserve a ranking or the seed they're at? And every one of them I've gone, okay, this is a pretty good quality team, because we haven't seen these teams up north. I hadn't seen the Layton Christians up here. Hadn't seen South Summit. Hadn't seen North Summit. These are quality teams, and North Summit right now is just hitting on all cylinders. North Summit has the whole package, Robert. They've got the big kid inside and Tyler Coleman. They can bring winners off the bench to replace him with the same size if they need to. And then with Calvin Hunsaker, wow.
What a player.
He is a player. He's got a crossover move that is as fine as you'll see. Now, not to discredit Delta, they just haven't played their game. And a lot of that is credit to North Summit. They've come out and they've kind of got them on their heels, and right. Delta hasn't been able to do the things they want to do. But my thoughts are this. This North Summit team, in my opinion, from what I've seen, and again, I've only seen a half of it, I think they're a top three team in the state, in the 2A state right now.
Yeah, I'd agree from what we've seen so far here today. Let's take a look at our first half stats brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Get to a better state with State Farm agent Brent Stapley at 438-5451. For Delta, leading the way is Jamin Bruff and Brett Roundy. They've got 5 points each. Bruff 2-for-2 from the free throw line. Roundy is 3-for-4. And then 4 points from Trevor Burton, 3 points from Derek Smith, 2 points from Dayson Fowles, and one from Jack Dutson. For the Rabbits as a team, they are 7-for-10 from the free throw line, so 70%, not a bad percentage there for Delta. And by my count, 9 turnovers in this first half. Obviously, that's too many turnovers right now for the Rabbits. And for North Summit, 12 points for Tyler Coleman. He leads the way. 11 for Daniel Stevens, all scored in the first quarter. 8 points from Calvin Hunsaker, 4 points from Hayden Blomquist, and 3 points from Jace Richens. And North Summit as a team, 1-for-1 from the free throw line. That one free throw coming from Jace Richens. No bench points in this first half for the North Summit Braves. And as a team, they have 8 turnovers. So both teams about equal on turnovers. 9 for Delta, 8 for North Summit. Delta with more free throw attempts and more makes as a result. 7 for 10 compared to 1 for 1. But it's North Summit is just dominating really inside and out right now.
They really are. And I'm sure Coach Topham's in there trying to make some adjustments. Okay, we got to bring help on Hunsaker because he's so good off the dribble. But when you do, he finds the open man under the basket. So it's hard to try and bring help to double him. Then you go down inside and you say, I got to bring help on Tyler Coleman.
Right.
I've got someone trying to front him. Oh, I can't front him. He's too big. They throw it over the top. So I bring backside help. Okay, then they go to the weak side. That backside, they come around for a layup like we saw before. I believe it was Daniel Stevens snuck in behind and got a layup. So they're just one of those teams that's just so hard to contend with because of size and athleticism, and they're just good basketball players.
Yes, they are. So North Summit leads at 40-20 at the half here on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. Once again, for gas, snacks, automotive service, and Champs Chicken, visit Eagles Landing or High Country Chevron at the I-15 North exit in Beaver. Throughout tonight's game, by the way, we're going to be looking for our Mike Smoothtown Offensive Player of the Game, our Dairy Queen and Beaver Defensive Player of the Game, and our Timberline Inn Sub of the Game, along with our Coldwell Banker Play of the Game. So we're going to be looking for that throughout tonight's game. Hey, by the way, Delta City, you can explore Western Millard County's ATV trails, rock hounding, Charlie White sites, 18-hole golf course, water sports, hunting and fishing with Delta City. Appreciate their sponsorship of this broadcast tonight as well. This is the Jones and DeMille Engineering Halftime Show. Jones and DeMille applauds the teams for hard work, dedication, and commitment. The race for excellence has no finish line. We're going to take a 2-minute break and come back and get you ready for half number two here from the Fieldhouse at Orem High School on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
Service Drug in Delta announces a new way to save money on your gasoline purchases. Service Drug has partnered with Silver Eagle and Delta to offer greater savings to customers of both businesses. When you spend over $50 at Service Drug, you can save 5 cents per gallon on fuel. Spend over $75 and receive a 10 cents per gallon discount. Spend over $100 and receive 15 cents a gallon on your next purchase at Silver Eagle. So shop at your locally owned hometown businesses and begin saving right away. As always, it's service first at Service Drug. Some restrictions apply. See store for details.
If there's a community improvement project in the works, you will usually find many of our employees in the middle of it, doing what they can to help out. They're hometown people, just like you. They belong to service groups, church groups, and other community service organizations that work to make the hometowns we serve better places to live. Utah Independent Bank, member FDIC. Hometown people, hometown spirit.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
The Intermountain Power Service Corporation is proud to bring you this presentation. IPSC is a community-minded company that contributes to our local schools, community organizations, and economy. The Intermountain Power Project consistently ranks among the best of America's coal-based power plants in reliability, cost-effectiveness, and environmental responsibility. Intermountain Power Service Corporation strives for perfection and is honored to be actively involved with Delta, Millard, and Juab High Schools.
And welcome back here to the field house at Orem High School. Once again, Robert Lovell with you alongside Ken Nelson inside the Jones and DeMille Engineering halftime show. Hey, by the way, let's give you the other scores that happened earlier today here at the 2A play-in games at Orem High School. As we started the day off with Beaver versus Summit Academy. Summit Academy tied with North Summit for the top seed out of Region 16 and won the coin toss. And they beat Beaver earlier in a tight game back and forth. Well, just a tight game like so many other Beaver games this year. It was Summit Academy winning 45-36. Grand beat Roland Hall 63-44. South Sevier topped Providence Hall 60-42. Layton Christian beat San Juan 81-63. South Summit upset Enterprise 58-48. And Waterford beat Manti 56-50 before Emory dominated Rockwell 93-34. So those are your score update brought to you by Beaver Medical Clinic with offices in Milford, Parowan, and Beaver. Now as we go to the second half here, Ken, what do you want to see out of Delta to try to get back into this one if they can?
Oh, boy. That's a good question. I'd like to see North Summit head down the road here to Texas Roadhouse a little early. They're just playing, they're hitting on all cylinders. Delta just needs to come out, settle down just a little bit, run your offense, take the open shots when you've got them, see what happens here. Right now, you can't look at the scoreboard and say we've got to recover 20 points real quick. Chip at it. See if you can get it down to about 10 going into the fourth quarter.
North Summit basketball to start this second half. The start of the second half, by the way, brought to you by Beaver Drug and Gift, and they're going to get a quick bucket inside. 42-20. Now North Summit back to the way comes Trevor Burton. He'll go left side, put it up high off the glass and in. Trevor Burton the bucket.
Yeah, and the whole coaching staff offered the team up off the bench wanted a foul with it. That's a nice effort by Burton.
Hunsaker across the timeline, 7.5 to go, 42-22 North Summit. Right side, it'll go to Jace Richens. Starters on the floor for each team. High post, it'll come to Blomquist. Left side to Stevens, out to Hunsaker. Off the screen, he'll take the long two. Off the back of the rim, no good, but he followed his shot and nearly got his own rebound, but tipped it to Jack Dutson. Dutson going to come the other way and a reach-in foul on Hunsaker. That'll be his second. And the team's first this half.
And Delta played that well on the defensive end. You'd rather have Hunsaker taking about an 18 to 20 foot jump shot contested than let him go by and go to the rim.
7-12 to go in the quarter. 20 point North Summit lead once again on the Eagles landing scoreboard. Jack Dutson will bring it across the timeline. Works his way left side with a pass to Bruff. Bruff one dribble, hands off to Fowles. Fowles inside to Smith, right through his hands, but right to Trevor Burton. Burton going to drive baseline. He'll block from behind by Blomquist. Picked up by Fowles. He'll go back up, blocked from behind by Hunsaker. Tries to tip it in, missed it short. And then Hunsaker, the rebound, and he'll be fouled by Jamin Bruff. And that'll be the first on Bruff, first team foul this half on Delta.
Yeah, great effort underneath there, getting a couple of offensive rebounds. But it's just tough to take it back up against the long outstretched hands of these North Summit Braves. They're just so good off the floor. So hand it to him, go back the other way.
Hunsaker across the timeline now for the Braves. 6:47 to go in the quarter. Right elbow, he'll go to Stevens, guarded by Dutson. Looks inside, and Derek Smith able to get a hand on it, knock it out of bounds, but it remains North Summit basketball underneath.
Yeah, running that same old spot offense there where you just go 3 to one side. All you're doing is running a back pick around the baseline and then a down screen from the free throw line down to the baseline.
Pump fake on the three by Blomquist. Steps to his right, does take the three, missed it short. Rebound Coleman, back out to Blomquist on the left wing. He'll come up top to Hunsaker as they reset.
Nothing you could do there if you're Dason Fowles. That ball just come long out to the big guy.
Again, getting open is Blomquist. Partially blocking the shot, though, by Smith and Bruff. And the rebound goes out of bounds off of North Summit. So Delta basketball. And Bruff going to go the length of the floor to Trevor Burton. He missed Dason Fowles, who was wide open, didn't get it to him. Now he gets it to Bruff, who goes to Fowles, and he'll miss the left side lay-in. Tips the rebound, though, to Bruff. Bruff, the eight-footer, knocks it down. Jamin Bruff with a team-high 7.
Yeah, Jamin coming to life there. And Delta a little bit on the transition there. I like that. Push the ball up as fast as you can.
Up the floor again comes Hunsaker. Crossover dribble, goes left side. Gets cut off. He'll hand off to Blomquist, and Bruff
nice.
Ties him up. Jump ball, possession arrow favors Delta, so that's going to be the ninth turnover by North Summit. Yeah, Jamin Bruff having a great, good game for Delta. Timeout called by Coach Priest. Under 6 to play in the third quarter on the Eagles landing scoreboard. North Summit 42, Delta 24. We'll take the break on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
Blackburn Recreation and Supply in Bicknell is Wayne County's not-so-little secret. From CF Moto ATVs, fishing, hunting, and camping supplies to farming and yard and field care products and ATV parts, Blackburn Recreation and Supply has got you covered. And when it's time to get the right tools for the job, they'll be waiting for you at M&D Auto Parts in Bicknell. For O'Reilly Auto Parts, done right, do business with M&D Auto Parts.
Delta basketball out of the timeout after the North Summit turnover, and it'll be Jamin Ruff to inbound. He'll get it to Jack Dutson in the backcourt.
That was a great timeout by Coach Johnson because some of the North Summit players were kind of getting a little, well, they're getting after each other. He saw it, called timeout, and says, enough of that. Let's get back to our game.
Pass goes to Derek Smith in the corner. He got stripped by Richens and then reached in for the foul. That'll be Derek's third big foul there for Delta. And that's also the 10th Delta turnover.
I can't even get a chance to say something here before North Summit's
right,
stolen the ball and going the other way. They're just so aggressive and so active out there on the defensive side.
Hunsaker across the timeline. Goes left elbow to Coleman. Nothing back door. He'll fake the handoff. Now going to drive the lane. Tries to scoop it up. Blocked by Fouls. Picked up by Smith. Smith coming the other way. Going to go down the left side. Pass up ahead to Dutson. One dribble. Blocked from behind. Oh. And a big foul from Calvin Hunsaker. Jack Dutson hits the floor, but he'll go to the line to shoot two. And that'll be the third on Hunsaker for North Summit. So Hunsaker for North Summit with three, Derek Smith for Delta with three.
And the transition game has been good to Delta. When they get out and run, that seems to be where they're a little more effective. Not always easy to do after you're giving up a basket right to North Summit.
Dutson at the Millard County Credit Union free throw line. First free throw, missed it short. He's now one for three from the charity stripe. Stockton Richens into the game as Hunsaker will come out for the Braves with those three fouls. Coach Topham electing to keep Derek Smith in with three fouls right now. One more free throw coming from Dutson. 5:31 to go in the third quarter. Second one is good. So Dutson with two. Coach Topham saying, come on, pressure him, guys. Step up. In the backcourt, Richens. He'll be guarded by Jamin Ruff. Ruff tips it away, but Richens gets it back. He picks up his dribble, goes to Blomquist, guarded by Burton. Ruff going to try to go over there and trap him on the sideline. Tries to go down the lane to Coleman. Coleman corrals it. Back out to Blomquist for three. Knocks it down. Big shot by Hayden Blomquist. He's got seven.
Wow, what do you do there? You defend on the big guy, and he finds an open player in the corner for a three.
Dutson left side. Steps into the corner. He'll come high post to foul. 15-footer blocked by Coleman. And rebound going to be taken by Blomquist.
That's three blocks, I think, now for Coleman.
Back up by 20 is North Summit. 45-25. Under 5 to play in the third quarter. Right side is Richens, going to drive baseline. Euro step, put it up high off the glass, no good. On the rebound, it's going to be out of bounds. Last touch by Delta, North Summit basketball. It'll be on the far side as Dayson Fowles dove to save it and hit it out on the sideline.
Yeah, it slid all the way into the bleachers down there. Looks like he's going to be okay.
4:44 to go in the third. Inbounding is Blomquist. He's going to lob out right side high to Stevens. It goes to Jace Richens. 2-3 zone now by Delta as they've readjusted the defense as they try to go high post to Coleman. Tipped away by Fowles, but picked up by Richens. He'll be blocked on the runner. And as he saves it, going out of bounds, it's picked up by Bruff. Then Richens tips it away from behind and gets it back. He'll go to Coleman. And he'll be
that
tied up.
That should have been a jump ball.
Able to strip it away from Fowles. He wants the foul call. Not getting it. Right side, they go to Stevens. And now there is going to be a foul called inside. Coleman and Fowles in a tussle right now. And the Delta coaching staff, both coaching staffs, having words with each other. Officials are talking to Dayson Fowles right now and Tyler Coleman for each team here. Haven't gotten an official word on what the whistle was yet. All three officials now coming together.
This should be interesting. Emotions are starting to rise to the surface here in this one as, the two big guys go down together. A little extracurricular on top of it. Let's see what they come up with here.
Going to call a double foul, one on Dayson and one on Coleman. So that'll be the third foul on Dayson Fowles and the third foul on Tyler Coleman. So they each pick up their third foul.
That's usually, I'll leave it alone with that.
4:21 to go in the third. It'll be North Summit basketball.
And Robert, we've mentioned this throughout the game. They've really let a lot of stuff go.
Right.
And I'm okay if you're consistent with that. The problem you've got is it starts to get a little more physical and a little more physical, and then someone loses their temper, and then you've got to start cleaning it up. And we'll see what happens here if we don't see a few more whistles coming.
Jason fouls a big block on Jace Richens after the entry pass. And now coming the other way is Jack Dutson. He'll hand off to Derek Smith. Pump fake on the three. Going to go off the screen. Drives right side. Blocked in a foul call. He'll go to the line to shoot two as he hits the floor. A lot of bodies on the floor in this game. And it's on Tyler Coleman. That's his fourth.
And there just was no need for Tyler Coleman to come over and create that foul, because you've got a guard coming down the lane. Just stay straight up, make him shoot it over the top of you. Now, Derek did a good job creating the contact there, but that's a big call there going against North Summer.
That is Coleman with his fourth foul now. Coleman and Dason Fowles, by the way, sharing friendly words now.
I think they were friendly, too.
That time in and out on the first free throw from Derek Smith. He'll shoot another. Into the game for Coleman will be Marin Winters. So another free throw coming for Derek Smith. Talking to the Delta coaching staff before the game, they talked about the fact that they've shot 59% from the free throw line this year, which is not good.
No.
And today, 7 for 10 in the first half and 2 for 4 in the second half. And now Derek Smith going to pick up his fourth foul, and he got him with the body on Jace Richens.
That was
so
a good call
there.
It was. It was a good call. You could hear Coach Topham here to my left saying, turn him, and he was trying to get with him. The problem is these guards from North Summit are about as quick as we've seen on the year. Just couldn't quite get there.
Jago Springer into the game for Delta as Smith will come out. So Smith with four for Delta, Coleman with four for North Summit. Right side Blomquist up top. He'll come to Stevens. Right side high to Richens. Into the corner, back to Blomquist. He'll rise up over Burton for three. Nothing but net. Hayden Blomquist now with 10. Third player in double figures for the Braves.
That's two threes for him. He can flat out shoot it.
Left side will come in the corner to Burton. He's going to drive baseline. Lost his footing. Puts up the off-balance runner. Missed it off the rim. Rebounds on the floor. Diving forward to multiple players. Jump ball. Possession arrow, I believe, will favor North Summit.
Wow. Great effort by both teams. Dason Fowles came about 15 feet to dive on top of that one. And he's playing with that bad thumb as well.
He's working on that thumb now. You can tell he strained it there. Full court press now by Delta. They'll lob it in, but overthrew the teammate. But running it down still is Richens. He'll go left side to Stevens. Blocked by Dutson and a foul called. So Stevens will go to the line to shoot two. The foul on Jack Dutson will be his second.
And you can see every foul that's called now, depending on who it's going against, the crowd comes up in unison to help the official make the call.
Yeah, you know, we talk about the fact that sometimes it takes a little while to get the football rust off. Both of these teams, good football programs, and it looks similar to a football game tonight. Dason Fowles is going to check out into the game now for Delta. It is going to be Brett Roundy. Second free throw by Stevens is good, so Stevens makes them both. He's got 13. 50-26, your score, 24-point North Summit lead. Dutson going to dribble left side. Nearly lost the handle, got it back. Defense tipped away from behind by Richens on the help defense. He's going the other way. Stockton Richens off the glass, missed it short. The putback, though, the follow by Blomquist. He's got 12.
That's great effort there by Blomquist to follow it up, tip it back up and in.
Gruff goes left side, and offensive foul as Stockton Richens had good position, and Bruff had nowhere to go but into Richens. So the offensive foul by Jamin Bruff will be his second foul. 13th Delta turnover.
Yep.
Fish Lake Lumberg timeout called by Coach Topham. 3:13 to go in the third quarter on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. North Summit 52, Delta 26. We'll take the break on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
You've seen Zions Bank's name at sporting events, performances, and fundraisers. We're just about everywhere. Your children and grandchildren see Zions dedicated employees in their classroom, teaching them how to save. We do all this because we have skin in the game. We support South Central Utah because we live and work here too. So we're as committed to this community's future as you are. When it comes to choosing to bank at Zions, rest assured you're selecting a company dedicated to bringing value to South Central Utah's businesses, individuals, and families.
ZionsBank.com, member FDIC.
And welcome back here to the Fieldhouse at Orem High School. 3:13 to go in the third quarter, 52-26. North Summit doubling up Delta right now on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. It'll be North Summit basketball out of the timeout.
Like I said, just when you thought Delta was making a run, starting to creep in this, you look up and go, wow, still down 26. So,
And they're going to easily beat the press. Driving is Richens. He'll scoop it up off the bottom of the rim. No good. Rebound went right through Roundy's hands, through Winter's hands. And last touch by Jamin Brupp out of bounds as he knocked it away from Blomquist. So North Summit basketball on the near side.
Yeah, great hustle there by Jamin. Just couldn't corral it, but he did get it out of bounds.
Richens inbound. He'll go into Winters, looking to hand off right there, but Springer, good defense on Richens. Now Stevens picks up his dribble and goes out to Richens on the right side. Up top it comes to Stockton. Richens shakes the defense, dribbles in, goes right short corner to Winters, back out to Richens. High post into Stevens, back to Richens. That's Jace. Up top it comes to Stockton. Richens. Stockton yo-yos, right side back to Richens. That's Jace. Into the corner it goes to Winters. Nothing inside, back to Richens. On the wing, goes right back to Winters in the corner. On the lane, they go to Blomquist inside. Ball got tipped, jump ball, and possession arrow favors Delta. So turnover by North Summit will be their 11th as that one got caught between about three different hands.
Yeah, and you notice that without Coleman on the floor, and they don't have Hunsaker on the floor right now, not quite as fluid out there.
Jager Springer for the quick three. Off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound tipped up, and it's going to be Stevens that comes down to it, and he'll be fouled by one, two, or maybe three Delta Rabbits. We'll see who they give it to.
Take your pick.
It's going to go against Brent Roundy, so he picks up his second, and that's going to be the team's seventh as well. So it sends Stevens in the line to shoot 1-1.
And that's another problem that the Rabbits are going to have now is North Summit's going to shoot for a long time. Over 10 minutes now, they'll shoot free throws every time they're fouled.
Dayson fouls back into the game. Brett Roundy will check out. Stevens at the line of the game is 2 for 2. Front end here is in and out. Rebound by Jamin Brupp for Delta. He'll push the pace. Pass up ahead. Stolen, though, by Richens as he intercepts it out of the air. He looked for Bo Nilsson. Couldn't get it to him.
Yeah, Coach Topham not too upset because they're trying. They're trying to run against North Summit, trying to get an early opportunity. Just didn't quite get it over the top of the defense.
Stockton Richens drives left side. Hands off in the short corner to Stevens. Misses the 15-footer. Rebound by Burton. He'll get it to Bo Nilsson to bring it down the floor. Nilsson across the timeline. Slows. Picked up by Stockton. Right side will go to Brough. He'll shoot the three. Blocked by Blomquist. Picked up by Winters. Just too long, took too long to get it released.
Yeah, and Blomquist is so long and athletic, he just went up and tipped it out of the air.
So now coming the other way will be Stockton. Richens goes around Brough. Brough able to get back in front as he slows him down. Left elbow goes to Winters, looking back door. Not there as the help defense is there. Right elbow goes to Stevens, 16-footer off the rim, no good. Jamin Brough runs down the rebound in the corner. They'll go to Burton, down the floor it comes. Over through Bo Nilsson, out of bounds. 15 turnovers now by Delta.
Yep, just a few too many. And again, another good idea. Just a little long on the pass. Delta, you know, they're trying. It's just tough out there against this athletic team from North Summit.
Jack Dutson back into the game for Delta. Jamin Brough will come out. 1:23 to go in the third quarter. Still 52-26 at North Summit. Neither team has scored for about the last 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes. Left side, Stevens has it, guarded by Dutson. They'll come back up top to Stockton Richens. Right side hider, Jace Richens. Now to 1:08. High post, it goes to Blomquist. Nearly lost it, but able to corral it. He'll go left side to Stevens. Now Richens has it up top, guarded by Springer. Down under 1 minute left in the quarter. Tries to go right side, got cut off by Jager. Now picks up his dribble, goes to Winters, looking for the give and go. Wasn't there. Winters faces up, now goes right back to Richens. High on the wing. Richens going to back out. Going to dribble in against Springer now, drives in, Eurostep, and he'll be fouled in the process, and he's going to go to the line to shoot 1-1. I believe that's going to be on Dayson. That'll be his fourth, and that is the case. So Dayson fouls, has four fouls. Into the game is going to be Jake Day for Delta. Coming out, Trevor Burton.
Yeah, so a decision for Coach Topham here. May have to bring Brett Roundy back, and he will.
So Roundy will come into the game for Dayson, fouls with those four fouls. 42 seconds left in the third quarter, 52-26 Braves. Doubling up Delta. Long look for Richens, and now he does take the front end of the free throw for 1-1. Missed it long, rebound by Day. He'll get it to Springer, who goes to Dutson to bring it across the timeline. Dutson, crossover dribble, going to go left side down the lane, blocked from behind, and a foul called. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Will Jack Dutson.
Yeah, that's just vintage Jack Dutson there. He's so good as well at getting his way through the tall timber and gets to the free throw line. Jack's had a good year for the Rabbits, both on the football field and on the basketball court.
Foul was called on Hayden Blomquist. That's his third, team's fifth. Dutson's 2-for-4 from the free throw line in this game and makes the first one. He's got 3 points, all from the charity stripe. Calvin Hunsaker going to come back into the game for the Braves with his three fouls. Coming out will be Hayden Blomquist.
Yeah, I'm telling you what, Calvin Hunsaker, kid's a player.
Yeah, he is.
He has really, really left his mark on this game, and it's not over yet.
Second free throw by Dutson is good. He's got four. 52-28. Full court press by Delta. The pass will come into Jace Richens. He'll lob up ahead to Hunsaker. Overthrew him, though, picked up by Dutson. Turnover by North Summit's there, 12. Dutson pushing the pace. 1-on-5, and nearly lost the basketball. Got it back. Now he does throw it away. Picked up by Jace Richens. He's going the other way for North Summit. He'll drive right side, off the glass. Got it to fall. Jace Richens now with 5 points. And we've got a foul on Calvin Hunsaker. That's going to be his fourth. They put him in for the final 33 seconds of the quarter, and he picks up his fourth foul. And I didn't see it as I was
either.
Marking down who scored.
I was looking down as well.
So Hunsaker right back out of the game as Parker Brown back in.
I didn't see a whole lot of any complaining from Coach Johnson.
Coach Priest. They have it wrong in that
book.
Got
it wrong.
Coach Aaron Priest.
Well, thanks. I apologize
Braves.
Then to him. He's if he goes back and watches the film, Coach, sorry, I got you wrong here on the program.
Up top, Dutson, 6 seconds left in the quarter. Crossover dribble, reverses direction, hands off up top to Bo Nilsson. Nilsson, one dribble, stripped on the way up by Stockton Richens, and that's going to be the third quarter comes to an end. 54-28 is your score. North Summit dominating Delta on the Eagles Landing scoreboard. We'll take the break on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
Sahara Motors is your no-problem car dealer. Hot weather, no problem. Cold weather, no problem. New car, no problem. Used car, no problem. Not sure what fits your lifestyle and budget? No problem. Not sure if you can afford it? No problem. Stop by Sahara Motors and talk to the no-problem professionals. You'll only have one question when you leave. What took you so long to buy from Sahara Motors? Just north of Delta and in Ely, Nevada.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
And we welcome you back here to the Fieldhouse at Orem High School. 54-28 is your score. North Summit with a dominant performance in this 2A play-in game against Delta. Winner go home situation. And North Summit well on their way to playing Emory next week.
And we should give credit. You said his name right. Aaron Priest is the head coach at North Summit. Impressed. There's a lot of good young coaches in this league. Curtis Toppin being one of them. Aaron Priest being one of them. They do
Ryan
a great
Judd
job.
For Waterford.
Yep.
Another young coach.
Absolutely.
That does a good job. Oh, yeah. Yeah, as you mentioned, a lot of good young coaches. Then you've got, of course, more experience. Let's go with that terminology with Coach Todd Jeffs over at Emory.
Absolutely. Yeah,
been
he's been around,
around
a lot of years.
I think 29 maybe. Is that about right? A long time.
And I'm telling you what, this state tournament, in my opinion, is wide open. There are several really good teams that could win this thing this year. I'd encourage you folks, get you a ticket, go watch some good basketball next week. Down at the Sevier Valley Center, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. It's going to be a lot of fun watching all these teams battle each other.
4 seconds into the fourth quarter, Jamin Bruff picks up his third foul as he, being aggressive defensively, tried to dive for the basketball and went into the legs of Stockton Richens, who's at the line to shoot 1-1 on the ninth team foul. First free throw for Richens in the game. The front end is good. He'll shoot another. That's the first bench point of the game for North Summit.
They're gonna be shooting free throws for a long time here. Still almost obviously a full quarter left in the game. And the next foul, they're going to shoot two the rest of the way. So,
Second free throw from Richens is good. Rattled that one in. So he's got 2 points off the bench. 56-28, once again, North Summit doubling up Delta. Kind of had that theme throughout tonight's game. Left side is Dutson, backdoor pass to Derek Smith. One dribble, pump fake, got the defenders in the air, and he'll be fouled on the shot. So he'll go to the line to shoot two. The foul on Jace Richens will be his third. Seventh team foul, so Delta will be shooting free throws the rest of the way.
That's a good basketball move there by Derek. Caught the ball, he knew he had people flying at him, so he just waited for him to go by, then went up and got the foul.
First free throw from Smith. Just snuck it in over the front of the rim. He now has just 4 points for the Rabbits in this one. There should be 5 points now for Smith in the game. One more free throw coming. That one's going to be in and out. And on the rebound, Jamin Bruff got inside position, snuck inside, but couldn't quite come down to the out of bounds off of Bruff. It'll be North Summit basketball.
Yeah, good hustle to sneak in there. Just couldn't control it as it came off the rim.
Delta defense drops back after they initially pressured the inbounds pass. Jace Richens has it for North Summit. He'll go off the screen by Winters. Behind the back as he goes by, Dayson Fowles nicely lays it in off the glass. What a take by Jace Richens. He's got 7.
Yeah, when he went behind his back, he just got by the defense and then laid it way up off the glass.
Right side, Derek Smith drives and scoop it up too short off the glass. Rebound by Fowles, and he's going to be fouled as he was trying to clear space, and the foul's going to go against Daniel Stevens. That'll be his 3rd, and that'll send Fowles to the line to shoot 1-1 on the 8th team foul. Trevor Burton back into the game for Delta.
And I got to give Dayson a lot of credit. He's been playing with that bad wing for a while. He dislocated that thumb a couple of times. I saw it down at Kanab. It was not pretty. Dislocated the knuckle on the thumb, had it put back in, and he's had to play with that taped. And I'm sure it's not a lot of fun when you get that hit.
First free throw was good, and he'll make the second one as well. So 4 points, 4 fouls. 59-31 is your score, 28-point lead right now for North Summit. Handoff goes to Stockton Richens. He'll bring it across the timeline. Jamin Bruff gets back defensively to pick him up. Crossover dribble, works his way left side off the screen by Stevens. Going to drive left side, puts up the runner, and offensive foul is the call. Drawing the charge underneath was Dayson Fowles. The foul on Richens will be his 3rd, and that's the 13th turnover by the Braves.
Dayson's taking a couple of those tonight. Very willing to put his body out there on the floor, so nice job there.
Up the floor comes Bruff. He'll go off the screen by Fowles. Going to drive right side. Blocked by Winters on the runner. And on the rebound, it's going to be a jump ball. Possession arrow favors. I believe it's Delta. Yes, it is. So Delta ball underneath.
And that's a perfect way to teach a big guy to defend down there. He's got the height advantage. Didn't have to go up. Just stood his ground. And the ball was put right in his hands. So he did a good job defending there, did Winters.
Left side of the pass comes into Bruff. He'll go off the screen by Fowles, goes back to Fowles on the pick and roll. Fowles cut off by Winters, now drives in. He'll be fouled on the drive, and so he'll go to the line to shoot 1-1. The foul on Winters will be his 1st. And the 9th team foul, so after this 1-1, Delta will be shooting it. 2 free throws the rest of the way, along with North Summit.
Could be here a while.
So Fowles at the line. Here's the front end of the 1-1. Short. Apparently this is the, oh no, that was the 10th foul. I looked at the fouls wrong. That was the 10th foul on North Summit.
I was thinking it was 1-1 too.
Yeah, so it is 2 foul, free throws for Fowles as he makes the 2nd. Dayson now with 5. Full court press again by Delta. It'll be Parker Brown that brings it across the timeline for North Summit, guarded by Trevor Burton. 58-32 Braves. Burton able to cut him off, and as he picks up his dribble, he finds Daniel Stevens near the timeline. He'll go right and say hi to Richens. Richens dribbles right side into the corner. He'll kick it to Brown. Brown going to drive baseline, and offensive foul. Yep. Dayson Fowles draws another charge. The foul on Parker Brown will be his 1st and the 14th turnover by North Summit.
That's
Coach
at least,
Priest didn't like it.
That's at least 3, though, that he's taken, and I thought he was there. Looked like a pretty good call. Dayson's really taking a beating tonight down there on the hardwood.
North Summit feigned like they're going to do a full court press, but as soon as the ball came in, they dropped back. Jack Judson goes left side off the screen, reverses direction as he got in the lane. Now backdoor pass to Jamin Bruff, scoop it up and score. Jamin Bruff now with 9.
Yeah, give credit though to Jack Judson on a beautiful, beautiful no-look kind of backdoor pass there to get the layup.
Across the timeline comes Stockton Richens. He'll work his way left side. Now comes up top to Winters. Go backdoor pass tipped away by Judson through the legs of Derek Smith out of bounds. And it will be North Summit basketball underneath. Tyler Coleman back into the game for North Summit with his 4 fouls. Bo Nielsen will come in for Derek Smith of Delta. 6:07 to go in the game, 58-34. Inbounding underneath will be Stockton Richens. He'll lob it out right side high to Coleman. He'll hand off to Jace Richens. Guarded by Nielsen. Goes inside to Coleman. Guarded by Dayson Fowles. The double team comes, and Jamin Bruff going to get him with the reach in. That'll be the 4th on Bruff.
Not only is he big and strong, but you just don't knock the ball away from him. He protects it so well.
Coleman at the line. He has a game-high 14 points in the game. And around the rim and off for the first free throw. He'll shoot one more.
That's a pretty nice touch for a big guy, too.
And you heard Coach Topham mention that in the pregame show, that he's somebody that can step out and shoot it. And we've seen him do it. Second free throw is good. So Coleman goes one for two. He's got 15 points for the Braves. Up the floor comes Bruff. He'll go left side, stolen by Coleman on the pass. And he'll get it to Richens. Richens coming the other way now for the Braves. He'll drive all the way in right side and scoop it up and score. Jace Richens now with nine. Really nobody stepping over to stop him.
Nope, it was a clear path all the way to the basket from the half court line.
Dutson off the screen by Fowles. Hands off up top to Bruff. Bruff going to drive right side. Hands off to Burton. Burton to the middle. Goes left side to Dutson. Dutson on the wing, guarded by Stevens. Goes off the screen to come up top. And now we've got a foul away from the ball, and it's on Tyler Coleman. That'll be his fifth, and that'll send Dayson Fowles to the line to shoot two.
And I didn't see what went on down inside. I was watching the ball out front and missed it.
Coleman will lead with 5:31 to go in the game with 15 points. And Hayden Blomquist will check back in for North Summit. Standing ovation from the North Summit crowd on the other side of the gym for Tyler Coleman, who had just a sensational game.
Yeah, I had him with three blocks, got the 15 points. I don't know how many rebounds he ended up with.
First free throw by Fowles is good. Dayson now with six. I would say he was probably close to the 6, 7, 8 mark on rebounds in the game. I don't think he reached the double-double numbers. Second free throw is good, so Fowles now with seven for Delta. Makes it 61-36, still a 25-point North Summit lead. Again, winner, likely North Summit at this point, will advance to play Emory next week at the quarterfinals of the state tournament at the Sevier Valley Center in Richfield. Blancos will go left side high to Brown. Up top it comes to Stockton Richens. Guarded by Bruff. Richens off the screen.
Whoop.
And he traveled. Picked up his dribble and took an extra step. Turnover by North Summit's there, 15th. Both teams turning the ball over a lot in this game. 15 for North Summit, 16 for Delta. Jack Dutson across the timeline. Backs out to the top of the key, guarded by Stevens. Right side, he'll go to Nielsen. Nielsen on the wing, dribbles middle, gets cut off. One dribble goes low block to Fowles. Fowles pump fake, going to go around. Blomquist puts it up off the glass, no good, but a foul call, and he'll go to the line to shoot two as Blomquist got a piece of it.
Yeah, Dayson Fowles making a living at the free throw line now. Just a little pump fake to get him up in the air, and then went by. This is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, his eighth free throw here.
All in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, he's really, really doing a nice job. It's too bad the game's not a little closer here to make these, you know, make it interesting.
Right. Makes the first free throw, one more coming. The foul on Blancos, by the way, was his fourth for North Summit. Second free throw is missed. Rebound by Bruff. He'll go back up. No good, but a foul called. And Jamin Bruff will go to the line to shoot two. That's going to go against Jace Richens. That's his fourth for North Summit.
So Delta not giving up, battling hard down inside there. Bruff has really come on here in the second half of the year. Has really played an important part here for Coach Topham and this team. He'll be back for a couple more years.
Just a sophomore for the Rabbits. He has 10 points after that made free throw. Second free throw is in and out. Rebound inside is going to be taken by Blomquist as he tips it out to Richens. And now Jamin Bruff again being aggressive, going to be hit with a foul. And that will be Jamin's fifth. So he's going to be done with 4:59 to go in the game. Will be Jamin Bruff.
Yeah, Hayden Blomquist picks him up off the floor. Shows some good sportsmanship there. So, yeah, nice effort there by Jamin Bruff. Shows a little emotion coming off the floor. It's hard to know you're done for the year.
Right. And he left it out there tonight.
Jamin
Bruff, max effort tonight from Jamin Bruff in this one. Stockton Richens at the line to shoot two for North Summit. First free throw is good. Richens now with 3 points off the bench. Under five to play, 62-38 your score. North Summit the lead by 24 over Delton, this 2A play-in game. Second free throw, short off the rim, rebound by Trevor Burton for the Rabbits. And now Dutson will bring it up the floor for Delta. Goes off the screen by Burton, going to dribble left side in the lane, hand off the baseline to Fowles, but ball got tipped, and Fowles will tip it out to Jake Day. Up top to Nielsen, left side back to Day. He'll hand off to Dutson on the sideline. Dutson going to work his way to the wing. Guarded by Stevens. Crossover dribble, looks to drive, spin move in the lane, and ball gets knocked loose. It's on the floor. Both teams diving for it. Picked up by Jace Richens of North Summit. Turnover by Delta as there's 17th. And Fish Lake Lumber timeout called. Appreciate Fish Lake Lumber. Drive a little, save a lot at Fish Lake Lumber in Beaver. 4:29 to go. It is 62-38. North Summit leading Delta. We'll take the break on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
Service Drug in Delta announces a new way to save money on your gasoline purchases. Service Drug has partnered with Silver Eagle and Delta to offer greater savings to customers of both businesses. When you spend over $50 at Service Drug, you can save 5 cents per gallon on fuel. Spend over $75 and receive a 10 cents per gallon discount. Spend over $100 and receive 15 cents a gallon on your next purchase at Silver Eagle. So shop at your locally owned hometown businesses and begin saving right away. As always, it's service first at Service Drug. Some restrictions apply. See store for details.
If there's a community improvement project in the works, you will usually find many of our employees in the middle of it, doing what they can to help out. They're hometown people, just like you. They belong to service groups, church groups, and other community service organizations that work to make the hometowns we serve better places to live. Utah Independent Bank, member FDIC. Hometown people, hometown spirit.
Northwood basketball out of the timeout. Calvin Hunsaker back into the game for the Braves with his four fouls. He'll bring it across the timeline, guarded by Bo Nielsen. Works his way right side. He'll come up top to Stevens, looking back toward Richens. Not there. And now they'll come right side of the elbow to Blomquist. Blomquist goes left elbow. Ball got knocked away by fouls, but picked up by Richens. Back to Blomquist, right side. He'll go to the wing. That's going to be to Hunsaker. Hunsaker tries to drive in. He'll be fouled, and so he'll go to the line to shoot two. The foul on Dayson Fowles is going to be his fifth, and the North Summit crowd cheering and waving goodbye to Dayson Fowles with 4:07 to go.
And Dayson, he's been a great leader for Coach Topham here this year, and he's a four-year member of the program. He's been a big part of Delta High basketball all those years and has done such a good job. He'll be missed, there's no doubt.
Brett Roundy into the game to replace Dayson with 4:07 to go. At the line once again is Calvin Hunsaker. First free throws he's taken tonight. First shot is short off the rim. Chase Fowles going to check into the game for Delta. And coming out will be Trevor Burton with 4:07 to go. Delta crowd giving Trevor Burton a cheer.
And Burton, obviously, as you mentioned, he'll be back next year. Great athlete.
Going to be a lane violation on Delta, but Hunsaker made it regardless. So the free throw stands for Hunsaker. He has 9. That'll make it 63-38, 25-point North Summit lead. Dutson goes right side to Nielsen. Nielsen, one dribble, picks it up, now needs help. He'll come back up top to Dutson. Left side, it'll go to Jake Day. Skip pass to Nielsen, overthrew him. Clear out of bounds. Turnover by Delta will be there, 18th. So 3:53 to go in the game. 63-38 is your score. North Summit leading Delta on the Eagles Landing scoreboard in this 2A play-in game. Hunsaker will bring it up, guarded by Nielsen in the process. Gets it across the timeline. Now it goes up top to Stevens. Stevens looking back door, nothing there to Richens. Goes right elbow to Blomquist. Nothing inside, left elbow to Jace Richens. Left open, he'll take the 15-footer, missed it short. Rebound by Hunsaker, he'll go back up and into the left hand. He's got 11.
Just showing you that he can go in and get an offensive rebound as well.
Jack Dutson across the timeline. He'll go right side to Jake Day. Jake Day looking to go back to him, and ball gets tipped on the pass and picked up by Stockton Richens for North Summit. Down the floor to Hunsaker. Hunsaker, the fast break, right side layup is good. He's got 13. 19 turnovers now by Delta. Just about a 30-point game in this one. 67-38, your score, 3 minutes to go. Skip pass coming to the corner for Delta. High three, and knocking it down for the Rabbits was Bo Nielsen with his first bucket off the bench.
Yeah, good to see that for Bo. He's another senior playing his final game here. Quality young man. I really like Bo.
On the right side, turnaround 8-footer by Blomquist, hard off the back of the rim, long rebound in the corner, goes out of bounds, and it will be North Summit basketball, looks like, underneath. Delta going to bring in quite a few new players. Jager Springer going to come into the game for Delta. Tanner Gonder along with Dawson Dutson. And North Summit brings Winters back into the game along with Parker Brown. Calvin Hunsaker still out there for the Braves. Rise of the pass will come into Brown. One dribble, he'll pick it up. Now go down the right side of the lane to Winters. Back out to Stockton Richens, guarded by Jager Springer. 2.5 to go in the game. Left side high post. Backdoor pass goes to Hunsaker. Put it up high off the glass and in. Hunsaker now tied for a game high 15.
I think you'll see him come out on the next whistle right here. It looks like they've got Wade Wolsenhelm off the bench. He'll come in.
Dawson Dutson is going to be tripped up as he tried to go around the defense. And so Dawson Dutson will go to the line to shoot two for Delta. Foul's going to be called on Parker Brown. That'll be his second. First free throw from Dutson. He is good. He's got his first point off the bench. And as you mentioned, Wolston-Human to the game four, Calvin Hunsaker four, North Summit. Second free throw from Dutson. That one rattled in. So Dutson, he has 2 points, and that'll make it 69-42. Stockton Richards will bring it up the floor now for the Braves. Guarded by Jager Springer as he brings it across the timeline. He'll go left elbow to Blomquist. Right elbow goes to Winters, looking inside. Not there, left elbow comes to Wolston-Hume. Guarded by Dutson, one dribble. Right side, he comes to Brown. Brown going to dribble in, handoff out to Winters. Up top, back to Wolston-Hume. 2:05 to go. Wolston-Hume going to be stripped by Dutson. Dawson coming the other way for the Rabbits. Going to go left side down the lane. Whoa. And off the glass, no good, but a foul called as Wolston-Hume just kind of gave a little push on the way up. That'll be his first foul, and Dutson will go to the line to shoot two more.
And I know you'll talk about this later in the pregame, or excuse me, in the postgame show, Robert, but what a game this is going to set up to be with Emory and North Summit next week, with one of the younger up-and-coming, a really good coach here, as we've talked about in Aaron Priest taking on the veteran Todd Jeff. That's going to be a good ball game, and that game's going to be a 2:30 p.m. ball game. Wow. So
coming out of the game will be Blomquist and Stockton Richards. Into the game for North Summit will be Brian Rodriguez, and you can catch the other number. I'll give you that one just a moment. Second free throw from Dutson. That one is in and out. Rebound tipped around, and it eventually goes to Rodriguez for North Summit. So Dutson made one of two. And it'll be Brown that runs the point. The other player that came in for North Summit was Wyatt Wolston-Hume. High post, it's going to be Winters. Left elbow, he goes to Rodriguez. 16-footer off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound tipped up, and Dawson Dutson comes down with it. He'll get it out to Springer. Jager pushing the pace for Delta. Left side, he'll go to the baseline short corner. 15-footer by Chase Fowles. Off the glass, no good. Rebound going to be taken by Wolston-Hume. That's Wade Wolston-Hume. He'll bring it across the timeline. And a minute 26 left in the game. Tries to go left elbow, kicked by Dutson as he got a little foot in the passing lane there. So it'll be North Summit basketball on the far side. The minute 24 to go in this one. Currently at 25, they're going to have them passing on the near side, it looks like, with a 25-point lead for North Summit. Inbounding will be Wyatt Wolston-Hume. He'll come right side to Winters. Nothing back door, and so he'll hold and now pass it up top to Wade Wolston-Hume. Guarded by Dutson. A couple of dribbles. Tries to go to the high post, but threw it too far out, and Rodriguez has run it down. And now there's going to be a foul inside on Wade Wolston-Hume. The foul on him will be his second foul, and that'll be an offensive foul. The 16th turnover now for North Summit.
Yeah, they're just running that old same old spot offense, and it's so hard as a player. You want to pick off that defensive man that's coming on this, you know, across the baseline. Sometimes you move.
Three-pointer by Gonder off the mark. Rebound Dawson Dutson. He goes back up too hard off the back of the rim. Rebound Chase Fowles. He's working on Brett Roundy, and he'll miss the layup on the right side. Put back by Dutson off the rim, no good. Rebound is battled for, and Winters comes down to it for North Summit.
How about old Dawson Dutson? He's played well in limited time here late.
Yes, he has. 47 seconds to go in the game, 69-44. Wolston-Hume goes right elbow to Winters. Nothing inside, he goes left elbow to Rodriguez. Right elbow comes to Brown, guarded by Gonder. Left elbow, turn around Wyatt Wolston-Hume for the 15-footer. Missed it hard, rebound by Springer for the Rabbits. He'll bring it the other way for Delta. Works his way right side. Picks it up and goes into the corner to Gonder. Pump fake on the 3-1 dribble. He'll step in for the long two. Short off the rim, rebound by Winters for North Summit. And he's going to be fouled by Brett Roundy, just with his back to him, kind of got him with the body. And for Roundy, that'll be his third, and that'll send Winters to the line to shoot two with 19 seconds left. Winters with looking for his first points. He's played significant minutes in this game for North Summit, especially with the foul trouble that Tyler Coleman had. First free throw is off the rim, no good. He'll shoot one more. And they're
not sure what this is all about.
I don't know if they're looking at the scoreboard where it says 14 fouls for Delta and 10. You usually just stop at 10. Yeah, that's exactly it. The official looked up and saw that Delta was listed at 14 fouls.
Well, and I'm wondering if he looked up and went, or if the other official honestly might have said to him, you honestly called that with 18.9 seconds to go. Let's go home.
Second free throw is good. So Winters makes one of two. He's got his first point. 70-44 is your score. 15 seconds left as Springer brings it across the timeline. Right side, high yo-yo. So pick it up. Lob it in the corner to Goddard. Looking underneath for Roundy and threw it out of bounds. It'll be North Summit basketball with 9 seconds left after the 20th Delta turnover. Full court press by the Delta youngsters. Pass will come into Rodriguez, guarded by Fouls. He'll hand off, didn't hand off to Brown. He'll go to Wolfstrom instead. 2 seconds left. Coach Priest just saying, hold it. We don't have to get it across the timeline. That'll do it. 70-44 is your final. North Summit will advance to play Emory in the quarterfinals of the 2A state tournament next week at the Sevier Valley Center. And Delta has their season come to an end. We'll take a 2-minute break and come back with the Sunrise Engineering postgame show on the Mid-Utah Radio Sports Network and Centricom Channel 10.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
The Intermountain Power Service Corporation is proud to bring you this presentation. IPSC is a community-minded company that contributes to our local schools, community organizations, and economy. The Intermountain Power Project consistently ranks among the best of America's coal-based power plants in reliability, cost-effectiveness, and environmental responsibility. Intermountain Power Service Corporation strives for perfection and is honored to be actively involved with Delta, Millard, and Juab High Schools.
Have you heard? Central Valley Medical Center is now providing orthopedic surgery. That's right, Dr. Joel Holman is a full-time orthopedic surgeon practicing in Nephi. You no longer need to drive to the Wasatch Front for hip replacement, knee replacement, fracture care, hand surgery, and general orthopedic care. Dr. Holman completed a residency in general orthopedics and a fellowship in hand surgery at the U of U and sees patients in the Nephi Medical Clinic inside Central Valley Medical Center. Call 435-623-3633,
623-3633. Blackburn Recreation and Supply in Bicknell is Wayne County's not-so-little secret. From CF Moto ATVs, fishing, hunting, and camping supplies to farming and yard and field care products and ATV parts, Blackburn Recreation and Supply has got you covered. And when it's time to get the right tools for the job, they'll be waiting for you at M&D Auto Parts in Bicknell. For O'Reilly Auto Parts, done right, do business with M&D Auto Parts.
Going into the tournament, not getting much of a challenge there. You got the rest of people. Now, I am a little bit concerned about, I'm not sure which one it is, one of the Butler boys. I think it was Colton Butler. Late in that third quarter, might have injured a hand. I saw him go down and was holding it, and so hopefully that's not going to be a problem for that young man, because they really need him going into the next round of the playoffs. But boy, there's a really good chance, Robert, that the winner of the Emory North Summit game plays in the state finals.
Yeah.
That both those teams are that good. I was very impressed with North Summit. I was impressed with their game plan. Obviously, they got a young coach there and Aaron Priest that understands his personnel, uses them well. They've got a guard as good as anybody I've seen in the 2A in Calvin Hunsaker. They got a big guy that might be as good as anybody I have seen in the 2A. And I know we'll get into this later. They were 1 point away tonight from putting five players in double figures.
Right.
I always said if you could get 3 to 4 players a night double figures, you're going to win most of those games. You're putting 4 to 5 players? Wow. Now, Emory does have some size to contest with Tyler Coleman.
Right.
But that's going to be a fun game amongst others next week. But very impressed with North Summit tonight.
They look very good in this 2A play-in game tonight, that's for sure. Let's take a look at our stats in this game. Your stats brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Get to a better state with State Farm agent Brent Stapley, 438-5451. And your stats for Delta. Jamin Brough leads the way with 10 points. He did foul out with just under 5 minutes to go in the game. Then you had 8 points from Dayson Fowles. He fouled out with just over 4 minutes to go in the game. 6 points from Trevor Burton. 5 points from Derek Smith. 4 points from Jack Dutson. Off the bench, Brett Roundy had 5 points. And then 3 points apiece from Dawson Dutson and Bo Nilsson off the bench for Delta. As a team, they go 22 for 32 from the free throw.